In this lecture, we will discuss the special case number 1 for Routh-Hurwitz stability criteria. So, special case number 1 is when first element of any of the rows of Routh's array becomes 0 and remaining same row consists of at least one non-zero element, then the terms in the new row becomes infinity and thus the Routh test fails here. So, to understand this type of case, let us take one example. This is the characteristic equation given. Fs is equal to s to the power 5 plus 2 s to the power 4 plus 3s cube plus 6s square plus 2s plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, in this equation, the coefficients will start from a0, then a1, a2, a3, then a4, then a5. We know that in the Routh's array table, the last row will be of s to the power 0 and the first element of last row will be equal to an. Here, since an is equal to a5, so we can take first element of the last row is equal to 1. Now, we will construct the Routh array. So, first we will take the highest power of s, that is s to the power 5. Then we will take s to the power 4, then s to the power 3, s square, then s to the power 1 and last is s to the power 0. Okay, so first element of the last row will be equal to 1. To construct the s to the power 5 row, we will take even coefficients, that is a0, a2, a4. So here a0 is equal to 1, a2 is equal to 3, a4 is equal to 2. Then to construct the second row, we have to take all odd coefficients, that is a1, a3, a5. a1 is equal to 2 here, a3 is equal to 6 here, a5 is equal to 1 here. Now we have to construct the third row using first and second row. So first element will be equal to 2 into 3, that is 6 minus 6 divided by 2, that means it is equal to 0. And second element will be equal to 2 into 2, 4. 4 minus 1, 3. 3 divided by 2 is equal to 1.5 we will get. Here we will get 0. Now when we find out the first element of the fourth row, that is s to the power 2 row, then we will get infinity here. So here we can see that the first element of this s to the power 3 row becoming 0 and this row consists of one non-zero element which is equal to 1.5, and when we are trying to construct the next row using these values, we are getting first element as infinity. Here we can say that the Routh test is failing. So to solve this type of difficulties, we have two methods. First, we will discuss first method. In this first method, we have to substitute a small positive number, that is epsilon, in place of 0 occurred as first element in the row. Then we have to complete the array with this new number epsilon, and then we have to examine the sign change in the first column by taking the limit epsilon tends to 0 to the equation of epsilon. Okay, so this is the array we have found out for the last question. Here we can see that here in the s to the power 3 row we have first element 0. So in place of this 0 we have to substitute a positive number, that is epsilon. And now we have to construct the remaining table using this epsilon. So now we will construct the s to the power 2 row. For this we will take this epsilon. 6 into epsilon minus 1.5 into 2 will be equal to 3. So 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon we will get. Then epsilon into 1 minus 0 divided by epsilon will be equal to 1. Now we will construct s to the power 1 row. Here we will multiply these both values. Then we will get 1.5 into 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon minus epsilon whole divided by 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon. Here what we will get? 0. Now we will construct s to the power 0 row. Since we know that first element of this s to the power 0 row will be equal to a5. Here a5 is equal to 1 is given, so we are writing 1 here. If we directly find out from this table also, we will get 1 only. Okay, so now we have to apply limit to both this equation, for this equation and for this equation, that is limit epsilon tends to 0. So first equation is 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon. This will be equal to 6 minus limit epsilon tends to 0 3 upon epsilon. So when we apply the limit to this equation, we will get minus infinity here. That means 6 minus infinity is equal to minus infinity we will get. So in place of this value, we will get minus infinity. Now we will apply limit to this equation. We will get limit epsilon tends to 0. When we divide this equation with this equation, we will get 1.5 minus epsilon square divided by 6 epsilon minus 3. This is the equation we are getting. Now we will apply limit epsilon tends to 0 to this equation. We will get this will be equal to 0 because here epsilon square is there. So we will get plus 1.5 here. Now we will construct the root array table again using these values. We will get this type of table. So here we can see that here minus infinity is there and here plus 1.5 is there. We have to check the first column of this array. So in the first column, two sign changes are there. First, the epsilon is changing from plus epsilon to minus infinity here. And then the change is from minus infinity to plus 1.5. So two sign changes are there. Therefore, this type of system will be a unstable system. And since here two sign changes are there, so two poles will lie in the right half of the S plane. So this is the example of unstable system with two poles lying in the right half of the S plane. Now we will discuss the second method. In the second method, we have to replace S by 1 by Z in the original equation. Then we have to take LCM of that equation in Z to find the characteristic equation. Then we have to rearrange the characteristic equation in the descending powers of Z. Then we have to complete the Routh array using this equation of Z and examine the stability. Now to understand this method, let us take this example again. Now we will put S is equal to 1 by Z in this equation. We will get F of Z is equal to 1 by Z to the power 5 plus 2 by Z to the power 4 plus 3 by Z to the power 3 plus 6 by Z square plus 2 by Z plus 1 is equal to 0. Now when we take the LCM of this equation, we will get 1 plus 2 into Z plus 3 into Z to the power 2 plus 6 into Z to the power 3 plus 2 into Z to the power 4 plus Z to the power 5 is equal to 0. Now we have to rearrange this equation in the descending powers of Z. Then we will get first Z to the power 5, then 2Z to the power 4 plus 6Z cube plus 3Z square plus 2Z plus 1 is equal to 0. So now we got the equation in the form of Z. Now we take this equation to form the Routh table again. First we will write Z to the power 5, then Z to the power 4. So in the first row, we have to take all the even coefficient. Here A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 we will write. Then we will take all the even coefficient, that is A0, A2, A4. A0 here equal to 1. Then A2 is 6, A4 is 2. Then we have to take all the odd coefficient to construct Z4 row. So we will take A1 is equal to 2, then A3 is equal to 3, then A5 is equal to 1. Now we have to construct the Z to the power 3 row using these two rows. So we will get 6 into 2 is 12, 12 minus 3 divided by 2. We will get 4.5. Next we will get 2 into 2, 4, 4 minus 1 is equal to 3, 3 divided by 2, 1.5. Now we will construct Z to the power 2 row. For this we will multiply 4.5 into 3 minus 1.5 into 2 divided by 4.5. We will get 2.33 here. Then we will get 1, then 0. Okay, now we have to construct the Z to the power 1 row. Now we will get 2.33 into 1.5 minus 4.5 divided by 2.33. Here we will get minus of 0.431. Then 0 we will get. Okay, now we have to write the Z to the power 0 row. Here we will get first element A5, which is equal to 1. Now we have constructed the Routh array. Now we have to see the first column to see the sign change. So here we can see that here two sign changes are there. First from positive to negative, first sign change, then negative to positive, second sign change. Okay, so since here we have two sign changes, that means this type of system is a unstable system. So same result we are getting for both the methods. So hope you have understood the methods and the special case number 1. Thank you very much for watching, and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.